Hello, my name is Erika Juarez, and today we are going to start with a fourth class, second grade in high school. The subject for today is housework. Okay, pay attention. Pay attention, please. It's very important that all the students watch the videos in different subjects. It's the best way to obtain an explanation from your teacher. For this reason, you have to copy your notebook, and in some cases, maybe print the necessary that you consider it in each subject. Thank you. Es muy importante que todos los alumnos, estudiantes, vean los videos de los diferentes cursos. Es la mejor manera de obtener una explicación de tus mismos profesores. Por esta razón, debes de copiar esta información en un cuaderno. Si no lo tienes, el cuaderno del curso, puedes copiarlo en otro cuaderno o en hojas, siempre y cuando mantenga el orden y la limpieza para que luego estas hojas puedan ser pegadas en el cuaderno del curso respectivo. Solamente en algunos casos y si tienes las herramientas necesarias, puedes imprimir alguna información que tú consideres. Muchas gracias. This is a special video for you. Es un video especial. When explain the correct way to wash your hands. For me, it's very important because it's important to wash your hands every day, in each moment, and for all your life. Because for me, prevention is better than cure. Prevenir es mejor que curar.
Todos sabemos que nos tenemos que lavar las manos. Ahora, ¿qué tan seguro está hecho este lavado de manos? Quiero que vean las deficiencias que podemos tener y dónde deberíamos reforzarlo. Los guantes van a imitar mi piel. Esta gota que voy a esparcir sobre la mano está imitando el jabón. Ahora, vamos a seguir las instrucciones que nos han dado. Palma con palma, dorso con palma entrelazando los dedos y mano contraria. Los espacios que no vean con pintura significa que no han sido ni siquiera tocados por el jabón. Nos han enseñado que hagamos esto y esto, pasos de nuestro lado de manos, sin embargo, miren todavía los espacios que tenemos. Vamos a hacer esto, tratando de cubrir toda la parte de las uñas y los dedos en sus puntas, y nos queda faltando todo el pliegue de los dedos gordos. Hacemos esto en ambas manos, pero vemos cómo se nos van quedando estos triángulos sin tocar el jabón. Parte de la mano que usualmente nos llevamos a la cara, nos frotamos la nariz, nos movemos el cabello y pensamos que tenemos unas manos correctamente lavadas. Miren cómo estamos. Por eso necesitamos terminar el lavado hasta la muñeca, garantizando que toda nuestra mano realmente ha sido puesta en contacto con el jabón y nos permita garantizar un adecuado lavado de manos.
Thank you for your attention. So now we are going to start with my class. The class for today is about housework. What is housework? Are all the activities that mother, father, children, every members of a family have to do to put in order each room in the house. Son todas las actividades que la mamá, el papá, los niños y cada miembro de la familia tiene que hacer para poner en orden cada habitación de la casa. ¿Ok? For example, here. Look at the kids. Is a housework. Clean my room. Repeat after me. Clean my room. Very good. Clean the bathroom. Repeat after me. Clean the bathroom. Excellent. Do the cooking. Repeat after me. Do the cooking. Do the dashing. Do the dashing. Pay attention. Repeat after me. Look at the picture. Read, listen, and repeat. Okay? Do the grocery shopping. Repeat. Do the grocery shopping. Very good. Do the ironing. Repeat after me. Do the ironing. Excellent. Very good. Look at the picture. Do the washing. Repeat. Do the washing. Clear the table. Clear the table. Very good. Load the dishwasher. Load the dishwasher. Repeat after me. Load the dishwasher. Very good. Make the bed. Repeat after me. Make the bed. Very good. Look at the picture. Pay attention. Take out the trash. Repeat after me. Take out the trash. Look at the picture. Pay attention. Wash the dishes. Wash the dishes. Very good. Don't forget. Repeat after me. Okay? Complete to read a complete sentence. Completamos para poder leer una oración completa. Number one. My bed when I get up in the morning. I make my bed when I get up in the morning. Yo hago mi cama, es decir, la arreglo, ¿no? Cuando me levanto en la mañana. Number two. The grocery shopping at the supermarket. We do the grocery shopping at the supermarket. Yo hago las compras en el supermercado. Number three. I usually my bedroom on the weekend. I usually clean my bedroom on the weekend. Yo usualmente limpio mi habitación el fin de semana, cuando tienes más tiempo, ¿no? Number four. My dad out the trash every evening. My dad take out the trash every evening. Mi papá lleva la basura afuera cada noche. Excellent. Number five. I the dishwasher after dinner and my sister eat. I load the dishwasher after dinner and my sister unload it. Yo pongo a funcionar el lavador de platos después de la cena y mi hermana lo apaga o lo detiene, ¿no? Number six. My dad sometimes do the cooking on the weekend. Mi papá algunas veces cocina el fin de semana. It's normal, okay? Number seven. My sister wash the dishes after lunch. My sister wash the dishes after lunch. Mi hermana lava los platos después del almuerzo. Okay. And my mom listens to music when she do the ironing. My mom listens to music when she do the ironing. Mi mamá escucha música cuando ella está planchando. Okay. Grammar. This is the grammar when you use when talk about housework. Okay? For example, I have to clean my room. Yo tengo que limpiar mi habitación. It's an obligation. Es algo que tú tienes que hacer. Es una obligación. She has to wash the dishes. Él tiene que lavar los platos. She has to do the laundry. Ella tiene que lavar la ropa, que hacer la lavandería. It has to clear the table. Este tiene que limpiar la mesa. We have to do the grocery shopping. Nosotros tenemos que hacer las compras, ¿no? They have to do the cooking. Ellos tienen que hacer la cocina. En otras palabras, cocinar. And what happens when talk about in negative? This is in affirmative. Tú tienes que, él tiene que, ella tiene que, nosotros tenemos que, ellos tienen que. And what happens when talk about for something that you don't have to do? ¿Qué pasa cuando hablamos de algo que no tienes que hacer? For example, I don't have to clean my room. Yo no tengo que limpiar mi habitación. She doesn't have to wash the dishes. Él no tiene que lavar los platos. She doesn't have to do the laundry. Ella no tiene que hacer la lavandería, o sea, lavar la ropa. It doesn't have to clear the table. Este no tiene que limpiar la mesa. We don't have to do the grocery shopping. Nosotros no tenemos que hacer las compras. They don't have to do the cooking. Ellos no tienen que cocinar. What is the difference? In affirmative, use have to, has to. There is two different forms. Has to with he, she, and it. With the rest, with have to. Have to, have to. But when it's negative, all use have to. Look, look and pay attention. Have to. All the sentences use have to. But what is the difference? The difference is here. Doesn't, he doesn't, she doesn't, it doesn't. And the rest use don't, don't, don't. Repeat after me. I don't have to clean my room. He doesn't have to wash the dishes. Pay attention, listen me, and repeat. She doesn't have to do the laundry. He doesn't have to clear the table. We don't have to do the grocery shopping. They don't have to do the cooking. Excellent, very good. So now, complete each sentences with have to, has to, don't have to, o doesn't have to. Completamos cada oración con cualquiera de esas expresiones. Vamos a darnos cuenta que hay un check o una X. El check es for affirmative. And the X is for negative. ¿Ok? For example, Jenny has to wear a uniform. Affirmative, because it's check. Simone doesn't have to wear a uniform, because it's X. Number one, X is negative. Jenny es una ella, sería un she. She doesn't have Jenny doesn't have to do a test every week. Okay? Number two, Jenny and Simon. Jenny and Simon o Simon, no problem. Son dos. They, ellos. They is affirmative. They have to have lunch at the school. Very good. So, here you have to complete number 3, number 4, and number 5. Okay? Don't forget, this class is for national emergency. This class is for you and all the members in your family. Be responsible and use the web and your equipment when it's necessary. Thank you. Goodbye. See you in the next class. No olvidemos que estas clases son por emergencia nacional. Esta clase es para ti y todos los miembros de tu familia. Sé responsable. Use el internet y tu equipo cuando sea necesario. No olvides de copiar los ejercicios en tu cuaderno y darles solución. Para luego, si los mantienes limpios y ordenados, más adelante podamos pegarlos o colocarlos en el cuaderno del curso. Goodbye. See you in the next class. Bye-bye.